heart is full. The privilege of making music with your teens, your grandkids, fellow students, middle school orchestra was a joy to hear you play as well. And I think when you leave tonight, you'll feel that our Democratic Republic is in good hands with the future of these talented young people. And we are grateful to your support for supporting Henrico Schools. And as a parent of two teens myself in the Roanoke Public Schools, how important it is to support all of the arts, including music education in our schools. So thank you for that. We start off with one of the great classics by Ray Vaughan Williams, English Master. This is a suite of three movements. There is a march, and then a slower intermezzo, and then another march. And within that, Daisy Colgan, Concertmaster, has some solos, as do a few others as well. And we invite you to save your applause until the end of the seventh minute. After that, second march comes back and do it. So, again, put your hands together for the All-County Orchestra, your orchestra.
Thank you.
not sure if you're all aware, but 2020 is the 250th birthday of Ludwig von Beethoven, and around the world this year, there are celebrations with my own orchestra in Roanoke. We are doing many of the symphonies, concertos, chamber music. This is a wonderful arrangement that incorporates three of the movements, themes from the Seventh Symphony into one. It starts off, you'll hear a little bit of scherzo, this really fast movement in rapid groups of threes. Then it moves into the famous allegretto from the second movement of the Seventh Symphony. This movement was so popular back in Beethoven's day, they wouldn't let him leave the stage without repeating this movement. So if you want to take yourself back 250 years or so, we'll do it just once, okay? And then it goes to the scherzo, the first movement, this wonderful rhythmic yum ba dum bum ba dum bum ba dum, this famous little motive, a rhythmic melodic fragment. Beethoven was such a genius, and this music remains so timeless. And again, it's so wonderful to see these teenagers just having the opportunity to do this. So these are themes from the Seventh Symphony, and happy birthday, Beethoven.
Thank you.
We turn now to the first of several film selections. This is by the great late Aaron Copland. Aaron Copland wrote this just a couple of years after winning the Pulitzer Prize for music for his famous Appalachian Spring. This is inspired by a novel by John Steinbeck, and it's called The Red Pony. It was a series of vignettes for the film. And when you think back to kind of the mid-20th century Western music, you know, kind of cowboy music, if you will, a lot of it owes a tribute to Aaron Copland and other composers of that era who were writing this music, and other film composers, including immigrants from Europe, would come and kind of imitate the style. There's a beauty, there is a simplicity to Copland's music that I think you'll hear. Very open, simple chords, a lot of American folk-inspired melodies. He collected American folk music and actually set it for orchestra and for vocal soloists. And so you will hear some of the images. These are music around the campfire. You'll hear a march come into the village. And again, some beautiful solos. Daisy gets a couple violin fiddle tunes, if you will, American fiddle tunes. So I hope you enjoy. This is less familiar music by Copland, but beautiful nonetheless. It is music from The Red Pony.
Thank you.
So I noticed they rolled a piano out, and so I've never seen a piano that I didn't want to play. So I'm going to do it now. This is also a film composition, and I have the privilege of working with our orchestras. I've composed some film music. We've recorded it with the symphony, and this piece, Concentric Circles, was written for a film that was done here in the Commonwealth, filmed a lot out at Smith Mountain Lake and also in Roanoke and other places. Stars Jane Seymour, and the name of the film is called Lake Effects. And the image of this is you throw a pebble in the water and the ripples come out and come back often in unexpected ways. It's a metaphor for many things, education, outreach, love, many things that matter in life. And it is a little mini concerto for piano. There's a full symphony orchestra version, and then there's a version for just piano and strings that we will do. And I want to dedicate it to all of the teachers here. I'm grateful to their hospitality to come in less than 24 hours. Thanks to the work that they do throughout the year preparing these students, and you as parents, I have the privilege of doing my music and leading these things there, but to William Raposo, his lovely wife, Crystal, for their hospitality, and to all of the teachers, let's put the hands together for them, shall we? In the movie, you have to imagine a scene by the lake on a dock. There is a woman practicing Tai Chi, and near her is a painting. Actually, the painting in the film is by my friend Eric Fitzpatrick. The leaves are changing in the fall, and the ripples, the light is moving through the leaves and across the water at the lake. Hope you enjoy Concentric Circles. Thank you. Thank you so very much. Well, we have one more piece. I think it's one of my favorites. We've had so much fun putting this together. Earlier with the middle school group, you heard one by the wonderful Korean American composer Sunhee Newbold. This is a piece kind of based on Greek myth. You know, there's kind of adventure in this, the slaying of Medusa. You can bring whatever pictures to this music you like, but it's super, super fun to play, as this young kid can attest over here. It is so full of energy and color and joy. I hope you'll enjoy. Perseus is the character, and hope this speaks to you, and at the end we'll stand, and it is a celebration not just of this orchestra, but of the whole region that supports the arts. Again, thanks for the privilege of letting me come and make music with your kids. Keep the love, keep the support of this going in Henrico, and hope you enjoy Perseus.